Good day. We are now bumping on the next lesson about the types of plate boundaries. Today, our lesson is about the first type, which is known as the convergent boundaries. On this type of boundaries, two plates collide and form different landscapes in the long run. Do you want to know about this? I have made a simple lesson about the converging boundaries. Keep an eye to our discussion. And lend me your ears to scoop science lessons as easy as possible. I, Teacher Dags, am very much willing to help my scoopers. Let's enjoy learning here on the Science Scoop. Before we proceed to our lesson proper, let us know the three simple objectives of our lesson for today. At the end of this video lesson, you are expected to explain convergent boundaries. Also, you should be able to differentiate the three types of convergent boundaries from one another. Lastly, this lesson aims that you appreciate the results of convergent boundaries. As our starter, I have here four words that will test your English vocabulary. Three of those words are somehow synonymous and one is totally out from the list. Among bump, break, clash and collide, which does not belong to the group? I give you 5 seconds to think. Exactly. We should remove the word break from the group. The remaining three words, bump, clash and collide, are some of the words used in describing converging boundaries. Converging boundaries happen when two plates bump, or clash or collide to each other. These arrows show how plates move. Remember, in convergent boundaries, two plates meet together and start to push against each other. There are three types of convergent boundaries. The first type is when continental crust collides with oceanic crust. The second type is about the convergence of two oceanic crusts. The last type happens when continental crust bumps to another continental crust. Good job, kids! Lithospheric plates such as oceanic plates and continental plates are somehow called oceanic crust and continental crust in most references, because lithospheric plates mainly comprise of the earth crust and the uppermost thin part of the mantle. However, you should also remember that the terms oceanic crust and oceanic plates are not 100% or absolutely interchangeable, because oceanic crust is being carried by oceanic plate. This is also true about continental plate and continental crust. Before we formally start our lesson on types of convergent boundaries, let us have a sort of comparison between the two kinds of crust. The continental crust and the oceanic crust. This illustration shows the two types of crust. From this simple illustration, you can clearly observe their differences. One kind carries solid and the other carries water. Continental crust is the outermost layer of the earth that makes up the continents and the continental shelves. In other words, this carries landmass. The continental crust is relatively thicker compared to oceanic crust, yet it is composed of younger and less dense materials like granite. Oceanic crust is the uppermost portion of the tectonic plate. It is composed of heavy sediments like basalt. Because of its composition or materials, oceanic crust is very dense and found under the ocean floor. Take a look at these tables and let us analyze both crusts according to their location, composition, density, and thickness. Continental crust covers 40% of the Earth's surface, while the oceanic crust covers the ocean basins. For the composition, continental crust is made up of granite and numerous kinds of igneous rocks, while the oceanic crust is mostly sediments like the heavy rock known as basalt. For the density, continental crust has only 2.6 grams per cubic centimeter, while oceanic gives the measurement of 3 grams per cubic centimeter. The light density of the continental crust will only floats on the upper part of the mantle called asthenosphere. In addition, in comparing their thickness, the continental gives a range of 30 kilometers up to 70 kilometers depending on the location. Thicker crust imply that the place is highland like a hill or a mountain. The same thing with the thickness of the oceanic crust. It measures only from 5 to 10 kilometers. The ranges of their thickness strongly suggest that the crust does not have uniform thickness. Now that you clearly understand the types of crust, let us now tackle our main lesson, the three types of convergent boundaries. Let's have first the continental and oceanic crust. The collision between continental crust and oceanic crust may result to geologic events like earthquakes and tsunamis. Also, geologic features like trench and volcanoes are believed were formed due to continental-oceanic convergence. How are these geologic events and features happen when oceanic crust hits continental crust? Let's talk about it one by one. Once the Earth's lithosphere moves, seismic activities happen simultaneously. Most of the activities are too weak to be felt. Time to time, people feel tremendous earthquakes. When a collision involves an oceanic crust like in continental-oceanic convergence, and the earthquake epicenter is located on the ocean, giant waves called tsunamis are possibly to be formed. Tsunamis are tidal waves that may cause serious destruction of properties and may change or end human lives. This short video shows tsunamis that hit Japan before. Japan is one of the countries that often experiences this geological event. That is why the word tsunami is originally came from Japanese words, tsu and nami, which has the English translation of harbor wave. As the collision continues over time, the oceanic crust will bend under the continental crust through the process called subduction. The lower or deeper portion where the two boundaries meet is called the trench. For this reason, trench is also known as the submarine valley. Trenches are the lowest parts of the ocean floor. As the convergence continues, the thinner yet denser oceanic crust is pushed under and go into the upper part of the mantle called asthenosphere. This process is called subduction. And the point where the oceanic crust has gone to is named as the subduction zone. Subduction zone is part of the asthenosphere of the mantle. The denser crust that goes to the subduction zone in the asthenosphere will eventually melt. The high temperature in the subduction zone melts the solid oceanic crust and turn it into magma. Having unequal temperature in the asthenosphere, hotter molten material called magma rises to the Earth's surface, forming a young volcano. After a long period of time, chain of volcanoes called volcanic arc will appear parallel to the location of the trench. In continental oceanic convergence, the volcanic AR appear on land. The first type of convergent boundaries may result to earthquakes, tsunamis, trench and volcanic arc. The second type of convergent boundaries is oceanic crust to oceanic crust collision. Like the first type of converging boundaries, the oceanic-oceanic convergence creates geologic events like earthquakes and tsunamis. Also, geologic features like trench and volcanoes may be formed. Among the four results, the formation of volcanic arc is visibly different from the first type. And we are going to point out that difference later. So brace and ready yourself and have appropriate discipline in our studies. Focus and listen attentively. As oceanic-oceanic crusts move toward each other, strong earthquakes happens on the ocean floor. This event may lead to the formation of harbor waves or tsunamis due to the sudden displacement of water. As the collision continues, deep region called trench is formed. Trench is where the two oceanic boundaries meet. When two oceanic crusts clash each other, remember that the older and denser oceanic crust will subduct under the crust that is younger and less dense. The subducted oceanic crust will start melting once it reaches the asthenosphere of the mantle. The particular place on asthenosphere where the crust is subducted is the subduction zone. As the crust turns melted, it is called magma. The high temperature of the molten material will make itself rise and reach the surface of the Earth's ocean floor as lava. Volcano is now formed. Young volcanoes formed in oceanic-oceanic convergence are found underwater. As time goes by, volcanoes become mature and larger, being visible surrounded by water, and appear as island arc or chain of volcanoes surrounded by water. To make it even simpler, let us compare the first two convergent boundaries. The two types give the same results. Earthquakes happen automatically since there is a continuous movement between crusts. Great possibility in the formation of tsunamis is expected since both two types involve oceanic crust. Trench or submarine valley also appears since one oceanic crust is subducted. For continental to oceanic crust, remember that continental crust cannot be subducted into the asthenosphere because of its less dense composition. In oceanic-oceanic crust collision, the denser crust goes under to the subduction zone. Since subduction happens in continental oceanic convergence and oceanic-oceanic convergence, volcanoes will be formed later on. The main difference is the location of these volcanoes formed. For the continental oceanic crust, the chain of volcanoes is found on land and named as volcanic arc, while in oceanic-oceanic convergence result to the formation of volcanoes in water, which is called as island arc. Discussing the movement as well as the formation of the Philippines is very complex. As you study this illustration, the Philippine sea plate collides with Eurasian plate. Here, we have a continental crust to oceanic crust convergence. As expected, the oceanic crust, the Philippine sea plate, is subducted. At the same time, some parts of the Philippine sea plate also collides to another oceanic crust, which is the Pacific plate. Since that the Pacific plate is older and denser than the Philippine sea plate, the Pacific plate goes under through the process of subduction. Many parts of the Philippines are formed in oceanic-oceanic convergence. As Pacific plate bumps to the Philippine sea plate, Philippine island arc is formed. Majority of the islands of the Philippine archipelago are considered as part of the Philippine Mobile Belt. These islands were formed 65 million years ago at the southern edge of the Philippine sea plate and are considered as part of the island arc. Other parts of the Philippines such as Palawan, Mindoro, and Samboanga Peninsula are all highland sections of Sundaland block of the Eurasian plate. This video made by Mr. Robert Hall shows how the Philippines and its neighboring countries in Southeast Asia were formed. Take note that a minor change takes million years. The video you have just watched shows how the Philippine Mobile Belt, which is part of the Philippines Island Arc, was formed million years ago as through oceanic-oceanic convergence. At this point, let us discuss how some trenches were formed between the Philippine Sea Plate and the Eurasian Plate. The Philippine Mobile Belt collided with Sundaland Block, which explains the presence of trenches such as Manila Negros Cotabato Trench System and Sulu Trench. At the eastern side of the Philippines, trenches like the Philippine Trench and the East Luzon Trough are both products of the subducting Philippine sea plate beneath the archipelago. The subduction or the downward movement of the Philippine archipelago creates active volcanic chains. For example, the descent of the West Philippine Sea oceanic lithosphere along the Manila Trench created a volcanic chain from Taiwan to Philippines. Some of these volcanoes are Mount Pinatubo, Taal Volcano, Mount Mayon, and Mount Bulusan. The constant deeping movement of slabs induces frequent moderate to strong earthquakes at various depths, gives rise to mountain ranges, and develops the geologic character of the Philippines archipelago. Check this illustration beside me. The color of the Philippine map shows the highlands in color brown and lowlands like plains are in green. Before we go to our last type of convergent boundaries, I am giving you a few trivias about the Philippines. The Philippines is the second largest archipelago in the world with 7,641 islands. There are around 20 active volcanoes in the Philippines. The Philippines is part of the Pacific Ring of Fire. Philippine Deep is the world's second deepest spot underwater. The Philippine Deep or the Mindanao Trench is about 34,400 feet below the sea level. Mariana Trench, which is considered as the deepest trench in the world, is formed due to the collision of Pacific Plate and the Philippine Sea Plate. The deepest known portion of the Earth is the Challenger Deep, which is located at the western Pacific Ocean, at the southern end of the Mariana Trench, near the Mariana Island Group. There are so many great and unique wonders in the Philippines. As the saying goes, it's more fun in the Philippines. Do you know any trivia about the Philippines? Comment down below. And if you are fond of trivias, I would love to give you some more in our future studies. So what are you waiting for? Be a good scooper and aim for perfect attendance. Subscribe on this channel and hit the notification bell. Finally, we are down to the last type of convergent boundaries. The continental-continental crust collision. This type of convergence results to earthquakes. And as the collision of the two continental plates continue, it will result to the formation of mountains or mountain ranges and high plateau. Nice try, kids. However, formation of trench, tsunamis, and volcanoes is not possible with converging continental crusts. To make everything even clearer, tsunamis, trench, and volcano formation is only possible when oceanic crust is involved in converging boundaries. The oceanic crust is destroyed and turned into magma in the subduction zone. Continental-continental collision will never exhibit the process of subduction. Continental crust is less dense and only floats on asthenosphere. Continental-continental convergence results to the formation of mountain group or mountain ranges. This is Himalayas of Asia. Let us watch how this mountain range has been formed. Himalayan mountain ranges and Tibetan plateau have formed as a result of collision between Indian plate and Eurasian plate, which began 50 million years ago. Another product of continental-continental collision is high plateau formation. In geology and physical geography, a plateau is also called as high plain or tableland. This picture shows the Tibetan plateau, the high plain which has formed as Indian plate collides with Eurasian plates. The converging continental crusts will result to earthquakes and formation of both mountain ranges and high plateau. Very well said. Because of converging boundaries, we can witness beautiful places. Many people also enjoy adventures and outdoor activities like hiking and camping. Also, according to science, the Philippines would not be formed if there had not been any movement. Before our class ends today, I have a simple challenge for you. I call this brain cells collision. In this activity, there are 5 items to answer. You will see 4 choices for every item. All you need to do is to choose the best answer. You have 15 seconds to think and finalize your answer. Are you ready? For number 1, the answer is A. Mountain. For number 2, the answer is C. Subduction. Do you have your answer now? For question number 3. The answer is D. Oceanic. For number 4, the answer is B. The continental crust does not reach the subduction zone. For the last number, the answer is B, because the Earth's crust is being destroyed or melted. Good job! I know you have understood our lesson. But before we officially end our class for today, let us have this inspirational saying. Bear in your mind that there are no coincidences in the universe, only convergence of will, intent and experience. By Neil Donald Walsh. Oops. Our class is over. See you next time. Take care.